When we have the formal education, mathematics, history, science, geography, we see to it that in this, when we teach, we incorporate 25% Islam in it. For example, when we teach science, we talk about the Big Bang Theory, that a few decades earlier, the scientists have discovered how did our universe come into existence. First, there was a primary nebula, then there was a secondary separation, which gave rise to galaxies, the stars, the planets, and the earth on which we live. Then we say, this is mentioned in the Quran, 1400 years ago, in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21. Verse number 30. Avalam yara lazina kafaru. Do not the unbelievers see anna samawati wal arda kanat ratkan faknahuma, that the heavens and the earth were joined together and we clothed them asunder. Now this, what the scientists have discovered recently, the Quran mentions 1400 years ago about the Big Bang. So in this way, the child comes closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the same time he's being educated about science. We tell them that the first person who described the blood circulation, it was Ibn Nafis. Later on, William Harvey made it famous to the Western world.